In this lecture, we study about manipulation of numeric functions. The sum of two numeric functions is a numeric function whose value at r is equal to the sum of the values of the numeric function at r. Okay, so let's suppose a is a numeric function. Let's suppose a, comma b are two numeric functions. Okay, then the sum of these two numeric function is a numeric function whose value at r is equal to the sum of the value of the numeric function at r. It means, let's suppose c is a numeric function which is the sum of this numeric function a and b, then the value of the numeric function c at r, that is cr, is equal to the value of the numeric function a at r, that is ar plus br. That is very simple here. Similarly, the product of two numeric function is a numeric function whose value at r is equal to the product of the values of the two numeric function at r. Similarly, let's suppose dr is a numeric function which is the product of numeric function a and b. So it can be written as ar into br. Okay, so this is the sum and this one is the product. Okay, so come to an example. Consider two numeric functions a and b, where a is shown as follows and b is shown as this. Okay, so now we have to find it out. What is the let c be the sum of the two functions a and b, which is shall denote a plus b. Okay, then how this c can be represented? So see here, cr is equal to ar plus br, and this is the numeric function cr, which is the sum of the numeric function a and b. Okay, so how this value is calculated? Okay, so see here, in this two numeric function a and b, okay, so we will see the common range here. Okay, so see here, from 0, the value of numeric function a is equal to 0 when the value of r is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 2. Come to in the function b here, so this is the value 3 minus 2 to the power r when the value of r is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. So we have a common here. The common range is r greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. Okay, so for this range, okay, so range of r, the range of r is 0, less than or equal to r, less than or equal to 1, then the value is, for this ar this one is value, and for this br this one is value. So this will have 0 plus 3 minus 2 to the power r is equal to 3 minus 2 to the power r. So this is the value of it. Okay, now since we know that the domain of the numeric function is the set of natural number, so we get the value for the number 0, 1, and come to the next number, that is 2. For see here, for 2, the value of this function is 0, and for r is equal to 2, the value of this function is r plus 2. Okay, so here, this is shown here, this r is greater than or equal to 2. Okay, so it can be written as when r is equal to 2, okay, so the value of the numeric function is, we can write it down for this, we can write 0 plus, for this we can write down this number r plus 2. Okay, so since it is single value, we can write it down, put the value of r here, 2 is equal to 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. So we'll get this value. Okay, now come to the last one. When r, the value of r is greater than 2, okay, or you may say greater than equal to 3, Okay, so when the value of r is greater than or equal to 3, the value of a is 2 to the power minus r plus 5. Okay, and the value of b is r plus 2. So just sum it. Okay, so this is equal to 2 to the power minus r plus 7. So we get this value. Okay, so this is an example of the sum of this numeric function a and b. Okay, so similarly, let d be the product of two functions a and b, which we shall denote ab. Now we find the product. Okay, so we have taken the same numeric functions a and b, and see here, we'll find out the product here. For here, for this function a, we just find out the common range here. Okay, so the common range is, similarly we'll get range, you write it down here, range 0 r 1, this is the common range here. So the we'll find out ar into br here in the right hand side. Okay, so we'll find out 0 into 3. Okay, so we'll write it down like this, 0 into 3 minus 2 to the power r is equal to 0. So we get the value here. Okay, and for this range r is equal to 2. Okay, so for this function a, the value is 0, and this for this function b, the value of r is r plus 2, that is equal to 0. And for r greater than or equal to 3, we have 2 to the power minus r plus 5 into r plus 2. When you multiply this one, then we'll get r into 2 to the power minus r plus 2 to the power minus r plus 1 plus 5r plus 10. Just multiply these two terms, we'll get this value. Okay, so now we'll write it down in the form of in concise manner. So see here, when the value of r is 0, 1 and 2. Okay, so the value of r is in the range 0 to 2, then we will getting the value 0, 0. So we'll combine together and it write it down in a single line here. Okay, now when the value of r is greater than or equal to 3, then we get the value, we find the product of these two terms, we get this. Okay, so this is, we get this second term. Okay, now come to another example. If A denote the monthly income of a husband and B denote the monthly income of his wife, then A plus B will be their jointly monthly income. So here A and B can be shown in the form of numeric function. Then when you find it out, A plus B, then A plus B is equal to their joint monthly income. Okay, so this is joint monthly income. Okay, come to another example. Let A denotes the balance in the saving account in each month and B denote the monthly interest rate, which fluctuates from month to month. Then A into B will be the interest earned in each month. So let's suppose B is the interest earned at the end of each month and which fluctuates when which changes, which changes, then A B is equal to nothing but where A is the balance into interest rate, we'll get the interest. Okay, so this is interest earned in each month. Okay, so this is this example 2 is the real life example of how this numeric function can be used to find the sum and to find the product, and what is the meaning of this sum and product in our real life. Okay, so this much for today. Thank you.